Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about triangles, specifically one property about a triangle, and that is that the sum of the three angles of a triangle always add up to 180 degrees. With that information, you should be able to determine the missing angle in any given triangle. So in this particular triangle, they show us that we have one angle that measures 80 degrees, and another that measures 45 degrees, and we have a third, we don't know what it is, they're calling it X, I'm just putting a question mark here, but what I know is those three things have to add up to 180. So there's a couple of different ways that you could do that. One is you can add up the two angles you know, you add the 80 plus the 45, that would give you 125. I'll call that question mark X now. And then we'll say, well, then what would that have to be to equal that? And all you have to do at that point is subtract the angles that you know, 125 from 180, and that means that X has to be 55 degrees. Another way you could do that is just say, well, I know I have 180. I'm going to subtract off the first angle, which is 80, and then I'm going to subtract off the second angle, which is 45, and that's going to leave 55. So do it however you like, but we should in the end figure out that that missing angle X equals 55 degrees. Okay, let's look at the next one. In the next one, it's a little different because they aren't giving you two of the three. They're giving you one angle, and then they also give you this little box down here. And what does that little box mean? That means 90 degrees, and we have a right angle or 90 degree angle. So what we need to do is say, okay, I actually know I have a 51 degree angle and I have a 90 degree angle, and then they didn't give this angle a letter, except I'm going to call it W because it's on the outside. What about the degrees of W would make that 180? And again, you can do that whichever way you want. Add up the 51 and the 90 and then subtract it from 180, or subtract them one at a time. And I'm just going to subtract them one at a time. In this case, 180 minus 90 minus 51 is going to leave a 39 degree angle. So W equals 39 degrees. It's as simple as that. There is a little trick about knowing that that's a 90 degree angle. Same thing here. You might want to try this one on your own and then see how you do. The two angles that were given is 35 and 115. And we have to know what that third angle is. Notice I'm putting the degrees on there because we should use units when possible. In this case, I'm going to do the other method, 35 plus 115 is 150. And I can just look at that and go, well, 150 plus 30 would be 180, right? But maybe you don't see that, so you go 180. Minus the 150 that you were looking for, and that's going to mean that K is actually 30 degrees. Anytime you're finished, you can check these problems by adding up the three angles that you think you have and making sure that they add up to 180. So that's 10, carry the 1, 3, 6, 7, 8, and 1, and sure enough, those three angles add up to 180. The last one I want to show you on this type is this. And when you see a triangle that's got a mark on either side like that, that means that they're telling you this side is congruent to that side. And that means you have an isosceles triangle. And when you have two sides that are the same, then the angles down here are also the same. And you can see that it says A in both ones. So that means it's the same thing. A is here and A is there, and those are going to be equal to each other. So tricky, tricky. What we know is we have a 46 degree angle, plus we have two of these other ones. We have A and another A, and that equals 180. So what you can do is take 180 and subtract the 46 that you know. And that gives you 134. And that's A plus A equals 134. So how would you figure out what one single A is? Well, you would just divide that by 2, and that's going to tell you that A must be 67. Because if you had a 46 degree angle and then a 67 and another 67, you could add those up. that's 14 plus 6 is 20. And then 6 and 6 is 12, 13, 14, 18, 180 degrees. So would that be 67 degrees each? So a little tricky there. And then finally, if you're given it in this form where they just tell you two angles, they don't show you a picture, it should be the same process though, right? We have 18 degrees plus 83 degrees, oops, plus some unknown. Well, let's call it X this time, something. And then we have 180 degrees. And so if I add, if I just do the other method where I just subtract 180 minus 18 minus 83, I'm left with 79 degrees. So X equals 79 degrees. Maybe I shouldn't have that there to begin with. Anyways, it's 79 degrees. All right, that's it. Finding the measure of a missing angle. Have a great day.